trainer Michael as he for the front of the strip, and they sent on their way from the 1400 metre marker, the opening leg of the bipod, and 1914 in the oranges right there. Flying Fellow with a good position, then comes Shoes and Company, and Tuscan is also, they make it a line of four. Further back in the field is Albert, who gives them about four or five length start. Money Doesn't Count is in the all blue. True Master near the rail with the white cap as Shoes and Company goes off to lead them. They're followed by Isobar. Further back, Emperor Augustus. That race is about eight or nine lengths off the leader. And Shoes and Company takes them to the 600 metre marker. Back in second is Tuscan, and 1914 has tapped the rail. Albert is back fourth. True Master pulls off the fence. Further back, Flying Fellow. Further back in the field, Money Doesn't Count. Then Isobar and Concatenation. Top of the lane, Shoes and Company, the leader. 1914 goes in for a run, and Tuscan's running on. True Master's putting in a claim towards the outside. And Tuscan comes home well now. It's Tuscan from 1914. Albert is running on in the pink silk, and the leader is Tuscan. Albert on the inside running a strong race, and here comes Isobar. Isobar erupting into action late, and Isobar is going to win it. Second Tuscan, the third place will go to Albert, and maybe Money Doesn't Count runs into that fourth position. So a cracking opening leg of the bipod race number two, and victory is for Isobar, who really erupts into action late, number one on the program, and it's Isobar for Wire Mowing. The gelding by Tiger Edge. We'll take a look at that slow-mo replay. Came from off the pace. And here's number one, Isobar, now recording his fifth win, the son of Tiger Edge. Tuscan fights on with Albert. That second place gets close. I think you'll find Tuscan will run into second position. But number one, Isobar, ends up winning it and wins it by a half to three parts of a length. Second position, I went with Tuscan with the orange cap. But it's number one, Isobar, victorious. Second position will go to Tuscan, that is number six. Third placing will go to Albert, that's number nine. And fourth place to number eight, staying on nicely, Money Doesn't Count. Further back in the field, True Master, and then 1914, Emperor Augustus, Flying Fellow, Concatenation. As you look at the head-on, and your winner comes to the outside of the track and runs on really powerfully. First goes around True Master, then goes between the two of them. So it's Tuscan and then Albert and two off the right-hand side. Here comes Isobar with a strong claim, and Isobar is going to win it. Second will just go to Tuscan, third to Albert. That's the second race, the opening leg of the first bipod. Next up is race three, the start of our place accumulator. And just a reminder about that big one, the pick six carryover, and that pick six is on 8.5 million rand. Starts off in the fourth race, 13:35. Back to the studio.
Raymond, when you're ready. A nice result here for trainer Waiho Mawing, teaming up with apprentice Brian Clarkson, taking 2.5 kgs off the back of this four-year-old son of Tiger Ridge. He had some pretty decent form coming to the race, and he's really relished the conditions on the poly track. Number one, Isobar, has come through to win well. Well, Tuscan really put in a game effort, but he was no match for the winner, one could say, over the final 200 meters or so. He'll definitely be one that many would have included in the bipod and would have saved many tickets. Number six, Tuscan from the Duncan Howell stable with Kevin Shea up. And Albert put in a very good run for the Mike Malaya. That's number nine, partnered by Donovan Dillon. But young apprentice Brian Clarkson, and I will watch him come into the parade ring and get into the winner's enclosure here. He's a likable young gentleman, and really nice to see him have a winner on this big day. And that's Waiho Mowing there with young Brian Clarkson leading in number one, Isobar. Well, we've just seen the running of race number two, the start of the Exotics on Vodacom Durban July Day. It was the first leg of the bipod. The numbers that will qualify will be numbers one and six, but a fantastic win here for trainer Waiho Mowing, teaming up with apprentice Brian Clarkson. Well done to the owners, O.T. Fisser and T.J. Smith. And, of course, this son of Tiger Ridge, bred by Marianne, Dr. Marianne Thompson's Ambiance Stud, now notching up his fifth career win and he's done it in fine style on the poly over 1,400 meters. Just waiting for the apprentice to come in, but before we wait for him, Wayo, nice to have a good start on the big day, second race, and you're on the board.
Yeah, you know, he's been knocking the horse. Obviously, I think the 14 is better suited to him. But just a big thanks to go to Owen and Tyron. You know, they're loyal supporters of me. They've been in a bit of a slump, but I'm sure this is going to cheer these boys up.
Very cleverly placed. He had a big weight, but you took a bit of weight off, and the kid rode a fantastic race.
Yeah, you know, obviously with big weights, you know, I think he's a very good apprentice. Obviously, he needs a bit of guidance, I think, and I think he can actually improve more this boy.
Well, you decided I'm going to be stabled at Ashburton, and your horses have settled in nicely. You got a number of horses to come later on. Just quick comments on which could be your next best, and a comment on Wiley Hall.
These, you know, all the horses are actually coming into form now. You know, obviously it's taken a bit of time for them to adjust, but I'm very happy with all my horses at the moment. I brought them to the racecourse to come compete today.
Wiley Hall, how's he doing? We haven't seen him for around 70 days or so.
Yeah, you know, we've sort of opted to give him a bit of a break. He's had a hard season, this horse, and I think, you know, I planned myself and Mr. Leaf to sort of bring him back fresh into the race, I think, is what we decided to do. You know, I'm very happy with him. I can't complain. I've had a free passage into the July. So, yeah, touch wood. I think we'll be all right.
Why do we always say well done to the trainer and their team, but we forget the families? Because the families, it's a different lifestyle being a trainer, and your family 100% behind you. Nice to see all of them here on course today.
Yeah, no, 100%. You know, well done to my whole family and owners, friends, family. You know, it's just nice to stand here on July Day.
All the best for the rest of the afternoon, Wayo.
Thank you.
Let's have Brian Klassen in. Young Brian, I must say, what a composed, confident ride from you.
Yeah, thank you very much, Diaz. Mr. Mike said I must just relax on him. I must be patient. And, I mean, he came out the pins well. I got cover with him. Mr. Mike said that he will definitely run on, and he should run a good race. And, I mean, he came down to the 200, and I was going so well. As soon as I asked him, he just quickened up, and he really ran a good race.
Well, when Kevin moved up at around the 300-meter mark, I thought it was going to take a good one to catch him, but yours was full of running.
No, definitely. He had a lot left in the tank. I'm just very thankful for this winner and grateful that Mr. Mike gave me the winner. And I'd just like to say thank you to Mrs. Fisser and company for giving me opportunity to ride this horse.
Brian, I know it's tough times for you. You're battling with your weight, but there's certainly a talent in abundance when it comes to race riding. And I just wish you well, that you can keep the weight down.
Thank you very much, Diaz. I'm trying at the moment. And it's always nice to get the heavier rides, you know, because they obviously are the better ones.
Well, it's always a great thing to have a winner on one of these major race days. You've done that with the one ride you've had. Going to enjoy it.
Thank you very much, Diaz.
Well done to young Brian Klassen here, riding for Waiho Mowing. Number one, Isobar, has come to win, beating number six, Tuscan Albert, which was number nine, rounded off the trifecta. And if you caught this quartet, the numbers you'll need will be number eight to finish back in fourth. Coming up next will be the start of the place accumulator. Please jot this time down. 12:55. The estimated pool, 3.4 million rand. And later on, we are looking at the pick six. That will come up in race number four. Jot that time down. 13:35. And an estimated pool of 11 million rand. Plenty to look forward to this afternoon on Vodacom Durban July Day. But if you find yourself in the winner's queue in race number two, well done to you.